Welcome, class of Environmental Economics 2020, here at the University of Amsterdam. I am your course coordinator, Yuri Sol, tuning in from Den Haag, and this is my proboscis monkey. In the coming week, we hope to surprise you with beauty from the natural world, look into studies that describe its state, and discuss theories and ideas that may offer us some help with our conservation challenge. We will go into both natural resource economics and ecological economics. But before we start, let me say a few words about Dr. Sol. He studied in Rotterdam, where he also obtained his PhD in economics. He worked on personnel economics and used field experiments in a retail chain that sells shoes. After his PhD, he joined the University of Amsterdam and worked on entrepreneurship for a few years. The Dutch national newspaper NRC recently praised his most cited publication. After Dr. Sol received tenure, he set up the course Environmental Economics and coordinates the minor program. We will talk about his recent publication later, and he keeps a blog. What else? He has lived most of the past year with his wife in Mexico. Many of the pictures he uses for backgrounds are his own, but not all. If a violation of copyright bothers you, please bring it to his attention. All rules around assignments and grading can be found on Canvas, and please self-register to a team at your earliest convenience or ultimately by the end of the first tutorial. Let us try a little quiz, and let's start easy with a true or false. All peacock named species are birds. All kangaroo species are native to Australia. And now for some multiple choice questions about paradoxes. Increasing the price of bread makes poor people eat more of it. Which paradox is this? Brass paradox, Easterlin paradox, Giffen paradox, Green paradox, Jevons paradox, or Meno's paradox? The observation that adding roads to a network can slow down overall traffic. Which paradox? And man cannot search for what he knows or for what he does not know. Which paradox?